legend is told of the long stretch of islands that lie isolated and fragile in the equatorial waters of the Pacific. A fisherman once caught a large moray eel living in the reef. He flung it across the sea, where it became the narrow, twisted islands of Kiribati. Today, the islanders still fish the reefs and catch the eels in their woven traps. In the small villages of Tarawa in Kiribati, the building of the house-like eel traps is a traditional craft handed down through the generations. Made from the pemphis tree, the traps are lashed together with coconut fiber. The creating of a new cage is begun with ceremonial rituals and entreaties to ancestor spirits to bring them an abundant catch. After the traps are smoked, they are anointed with coconut milk. A secret incantation, known only to the family, is said over the new trap. Sinker stones are secured to the sides to weight the traps down into the deep waters. An inner channel is made to prevent the eel from escaping. An access hole or doorway opens in the front. At night, by moonlight, and armed with lamps, the drama of the hunt for bait unfolds. With grotesque skill, the villagers bite out the eyes of octopus to kill them. Fishermen of Kiribati are among the most fearless sea people of the Pacific. Their life is spent on the ocean and on narrow, low-lying atolls, many of which rise to no more than a meter or so above sea level. Beyond the reefs, the traps, baited with octopus, are lowered. They become underwater houses, strange and enticing to the eels. A day or two will pass, with the cages resting silently on the seabed. Then the fishermen return. Yep. can be more than a meter long, is an aggressive house guest with sharp and vicious teeth. Of Kiribati, the traditional way for cooking the eel is in an umunu, an underground oven. Curled up on a woven leaf platter, the eel becomes a feast for the family. And so the cycle repeats itself. The myth of the fisherman and the eel was created out of a need to be part of nature. And the islanders are still sustained by this belief. It is the ground they walk on and the food they eat. It is a link to their ancestor spirits and part of the energy of their daily life on the atolls.
As a canoe. Our land is both fragile and limited, so we extend our world to include the sea and the sky. The canoe carries us into the heart of nature, our sea world.